Guitars for Vets. I'm an instructor with the Guitars for Vets Learning Center. Let's take a look at Toby Keith's Beer for My Horses. This was a duet that he did several years back with Willie Nelson. What's really neat about this song is there's some cool embellishments for the beginner, intermediate player. The intro, we've got some really nice nuggets to kind of talk through. You've got some double stops, string muting. All right, single note picking, slide, hammer-ons and pull-offs. All right, so there's a whole lot of stuff going on in there, and my suggestion would be just take your time in trying to figure out each section of that intro. So the first part, double stops and a string mute. All right, we're taking the third and fourth fingers, placing it on the fifth fret, first and second strings, and we're doing a walk down on that second string. Playing two strings at the same time, double stops. And then we're going to move to the third string and mute the second string with our third finger. So we're playing the third string and the first string while muting the second. Single notes. Again on that beginning. All right. First part of the intro. The next part is you're going to do a slide from the fifth to the second fret on the third string, and then you're going to pull off and then hammer on. All right. And then let's move from the third string to the fourth string. Move from the fourth to the fifth string. You can slide or you can hammer on. And then from the fifth string to the sixth string. Okay, that's the intro. You can use that as the outro as well, too. So, again, a lot of neat things that are happening in that part of the song. And just take it, you know, one section at a time. And then when you're feeling like you've accomplished learning that, playing it the right way, then move on to the next section of that intro. And at the very end, play it slowly and then increase speed as you become much more at playing it cleanly. And then once you're up to speed, move on to the rest of the song. All right, so now let's go through the strumming pattern and the chords that are used in this song. Let's take a look at the chord chart. We've got open chords, A, D, E, G, and there is an F sharp minor. That's an E minor chord form. So you're gonna start with an E minor, move up two frets, and then put that first finger on the second fret. That's your F sharp minor. The strumming pattern, you know, strumming pattern that we've learned in iTag. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, Now, if you want to try something a little fancier, you can, every time you play A, try playing a little shuffle there. And that shuffle is what's used in blues. What we're doing is we're taking this A form, and we're taking that third finger, and on the fourth string, we're just alternating between these two notes. Let's see, chord changes. Let's see, every time you throw that F sharp minor in there, it's going to be quick. So what you'll want to do is try practicing the chord that goes into the F sharp minor. In this case, it's an A. Okay. Get your muscle memory working. Start with an A. Form that F sharp minor and practice it slowly until you play it cleanly, and then increase the speed just a little bit. So that's that chord transition is going to come up fairly quickly, so you want to be ready for it. Let's go ahead and play through the whole song, all right?
Draw all night when the gun smoke settles, we'll sing a victory to